Hi, and welcome to Making Music. My name is Dan Arony, and I will be your host for the next half hour. This show is sponsored by Guitar Showcase in San Jose, California, and I've been with them since August 28, 1974, 9:45 a.m., but who's counting? Now, for you musicians and preschoolers, that's 32 years, but I don't mean to give a bad rap to the preschoolers. This show will focus on the local musicians and all the great stories that go along with them, including my guest today. We'll also be talking about vintage guitars, vintage amps, and that whole vintage market that seems to be exploding right now. It's even since 6 months ago, the market has gone 30 to 40%. And we'll also be talking about these little guys right here. We have a gentleman in, Val King from King Amplification, and he's going to be talking about tubes. Now, this little guy right here, a 6L6GC, is still ruling the roost after 50, 60 years. That's no explanation with all the digital and analog that's on the market, but here it is. It's been great, and we'll be talking about tube amps and vintage tube as well. But our show, this show today, is actually starting with a phone call I got from my guest today, Brian Connors. And he called me last October, got on the phone, and he said, Dan, my buddy Herbie is selling his recording studio, Cyclops, and some of the gear, and I need someone to come help me appraise it. And can we meet and go up? And so without further ado, I'd like to introduce my guest and friend and musician, Brian Connors.
Thank you, Dan.
Thank you for being with us today. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, so I must first confess that by day I'm a venture capitalist, so I've... Although I've been playing guitar since I was 7 years old, which is far too long than I'd rather recount, but been a passionate musician. And by night, I play in a regular band, and I'm also an avid guitar collector.
Well, talk about formative ventures. I want to
hear. Okay, so formative ventures. Yeah, that was this follows my 30-year career in the high-tech game, starting in 1970-something. When my dad advised me to, maybe in case this guitar thing didn't work out, it would be a good idea to get an engineering education.
Now, can I say something real quick? Because when I think about venture capitalists, I love that word venture because I think about a Star Trek episode and to go where no man has gone before with capital.
It could be called adventure capital. There are certainly plenty of times in which it was more of an adventure than I'd like. But, yeah, following a career in several startup companies, LSI Logic Corporation, Synopsys, C-Cube, very successful, and decided to get into the side where I'm actually helping finance some of the new ventures in Silicon Valley.
Now, how does that go into Herbie now?
You got to have a lot of money to buy vintage guitars and things, so you got to have a real job.
Now, talk about the how you got involved with Herbie, because I know that was through a venture capital.
In a way, yeah. To getting involved with Herbie, it goes back to my passion as a kid in high school to one day own a recording studio, and I did. After my first success in Silicon Valley, bought a recording studio, TRS, in Sunnyvale. Worked that with my partner, Scotty Smith, for 20 years probably. And later in that adventure, we set up a small independent record label called Tree Fort Records, because the studio we nicknamed the Tree Fort because it was a comfortable place to hang out. We had some great local acts, one of which was Inca.
Now we have a picture here.
Yeah, we do.
Actually, we can right here. With a picture of you holding a picture that says Abraxas Inca Inca with Herbie Herbert.
Right, so that's, it actually was that Inca was our band, Herbie was with Abraxas. Abraxas was a band, it was basically the old Santana band, Les Carlos Santana. So it was Neil Sean and Greg Raleigh, and I think Ross Valerie played. And it just so happened that at one time my band and his band were performing together at the Fillmore. And but it turns out that's not the first time I met Herbie. I mean, it wasn't then that I met Herbie. I met Herbie one time when our band, Inca Inca, won some BAMMY Awards. I got involved with Tom Lipinski, who was the producer of the BAMMYs, a friend of his, Tom Panos. We all became good buddies, and it was Tom, really the Toms, that introduced me to Herbie, and we made the connection.
And I know Tom also because he was running Mountain Winery for
a while. That's correct. In fact, that's the original time I met Tom was Tom Lipinski, that is. We were actually considering buying the Mountain Winery and putting those concerts back on. And that was, that we was going to run it and I was going to own it. And then another group came in and bought it. But the good thing is it's back in operation.
Yeah. Well, let's go back to our buy now. we have this, I get this call in October from you, and it's exciting. I got to tell you, I was just thrilled.
That was a day.
You call me and you say, Brian, you know, Herbie has this collection. I didn't know, I swear I'm out of the loop, I guess, a little bit, because I didn't really know Herbie's background. And so I get the call. We meet up at your place off Sand Hill Road, and we drive up to his studio.
All right. Well, it came about very serendipitously, because it was actually, I was at a gig of Lenny Williams, the Lenny Williams band. Lenny used to be the front man and lead singer for Tower of Power and their big hits and so forth. And so after the show, I was talking to Lenny one day, and he says, "Do you know that Herbie Herbert's selling a studio?" And I'm like, "No, I hadn't talked to Herbie at the time in a year." And so I said, I was just shocked. In my mind immediately, I mean, I love Herbie dearly, and I'm embarrassed to say this, but my mind immediately went to the vintage gear.
Yeah.
And so I went up and talked to Herbie about it, and we couldn't decide, you know, how to do this properly. So I said, I've got an idea. I'll call my buddy Dan at Showcase. He's an expert. We'll get up here and do some appraisals. And I think I told you that maybe if you were real nice to him, he'd let you buy a few
pieces.
That's
correct. You sure did. And I'll tell you, what a treat. Is we get to the building, and this building is such a sty from the outside.
Decrepit, yeah.
I mean, absolutely decrepit looking. But if you want to hide great gear and not you know, have anyone pay any attention to this building, that was the building.
Yeah. I mean,